I used to love lemons growing up, and this is one of those lemons. You should take your fingernail. Oh my goodness. You know how often I get these kind of lemons? Rarely. Hold on, let the juices come out. Oh, this is taking me back to college. Put a little bit of salt, flip it inside out.
And then you eat it. Mr. Peach.
On this edition of Cooking with Strider, we are making college spaghetti, or as I used to fondly call it, broke skitty. My parents couldn't afford to pay for my college. I took out a bunch of loans and I didn't have much money left over from that. I used to work a job doing massage therapy. I abruptly quit when I got my degree. During those times, I was too prideful to ask my mother or my father for money for food. But my mother would come and visit and she would see what was in my pantry and she's like, ah! And she would go to the store and stalk me up. But I couldn't. I'm like, I can do this, Mom. I can do this on my own. And then 10 years later, I paid off my debt. So that was fun. I've been cooking this lately because it's been so good. It's really easy, it's really fast, and it's really cheap. So all you need, ground beef and some sauce. We like rouse. I wasn't getting no rouse when I was in college. I was getting like schmouse, and that was just fine. Rouse is really good for people doing keto stuff because the carb count is super low. Now here comes the other fun part. You can put whatever noodle in there, so cheap. I used to do different kinds of noodles. Now we use this palmini, but I have to tell you, I've had the shirataki kind. Shirataki, I can't say that right. Shikatala. And it's better. It's a little less crunchy. This tastes like a vegetable, and the shirataki stuff tastes kind of like a noodle, and it's not. And this is it. We're gonna use some spices, but it really doesn't matter because broke skatty, you use what you use. You got what you got. You make it happen. Put a little oil. Yes, ma'am. Oh, that was actually pretty. And we put it on high heat because I didn't know any different any other way. High heat means fast, right? Let's do this. Oh my gosh, you know what else I used to do in college? So McDonald's used to have this two for two. Two cheeseburgers for $2. Two french fries for $2. I had lunch and dinner and my gut didn't come out half bad. I only have a few mild like digestion issues from that. Let's toss it in. Woo woo! It goes very fast, by the way. Another reason why I liked it, because who had time? I was working on the weekends, and then I would go to school during the weekdays, and I was able to do enough massage. I was exhausted, but it got me through my rent and my bills and my gas. So this was actually a treat. Then I moved to Austin. Not look back once. Getting to know Strider. This is what I like to call beat it, cut it, kill it. Dice it, make it work. Oh my gosh, this is my spaghetti confessionals. Remember when I used to have my pantry confessionals, which I have cleaned. Ha ha. Ooh, this used to happen a lot back then too. Having ADD with Strider. So I was never taught any like ancient recipes from my grandpa's grandpa, nothing like that at all. Where I learned to do a lot of my cooking was my stepmom's. I learned a lot of Middle Eastern food. It's so good.
Hey, Ben. Hey.
We're having broke sketty tonight. Don't you love this?
I love it so much.
So my thinking back then was make sure it's brown because I don't need to be sick.
You know, I'm getting a little worried about our meal listening to all this.
Look, man, you've been eating this. I've been cooking this like twice a week for the last 3 months.
It's good for my immune system.
It's easy. It's fast and it's cheap. And you go to Costco, you get four of them things. No, three of those things. Why do they have such big things? Did you see these apples that they brought in from Costco? This is my hand. This apple is massive.
They're huge.
Why is everything so big there? Is there somebody that goes there and is like, not big enough. Needs to be bigger. While this is at the cooking stage, this is where I like to add stuff. All right, salt and pepper, yes. Pepper, 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 pepper. Look, all I know is you can go crazy with spices, but if you put too much salt, it's inedible. You put too much pepper or anything else, you know, walk it off. But too much salt, your nose bleeds.
Yeah.
My dad used to always make fajitas, and he would always use fajita seasoning. When I left to college, they sent me with stuff that I didn't know what to do with. One of them was fajita seasoning. I've been putting fajita seasoning in my broke sketty for 30 years now. What's that? Yeah, 30, no, that'd be 20, Fajita seasoning. Also, to that mix, they had lemon pepper in there. Don't know why, don't know what, gonna use it. Lemon pepper, garlic powder was added to the mix. I had these three as my staples. Always put it into this instead of straight because I've had horrible accidents that way. Garlic powder. The other thing that was in there, chili powder. Now this is a fancy one. I don't know where I got it or why I got it. I wanted the regular one. I wanted Bruschetti chili powder. I wanted fancy stuff. Give me some Bruschetti chili powder. But this is all I could find that day. And it works. And now we stir. Okay, we're almost there, but the problem is this gets a lot of juice, so I need to toss it. I'm not the best at this, but that's not the problem. I don't want all the juice. It makes it greasy and weird. Okay, I'm working on it. Hang on, baby. I see you. Just, it's heavy. No, no, no. Okay, we're good. We're good. College spaghetti's a one-pot shot. This? Goes in there. Oh, it smells delicious. And really all we're trying to do is warm it up. As this warms up, the next step you would do was add your already cooked spaghetti and put it in there. And then you add a bunch of stuff. We're doing this keto stuff. We don't add that anymore because we like this as a stew because it just turns out awesome. This is where it would end. That's it for Bruschetti. Now we're gonna go through my refrigerator and see what we have to add to the Bruschetti to just beef it up some. Because I have a feeling if I add these little mozzarella balls, they would be so tasty. And I just got these in from Costco. Why are there so many? Put some of that in there. And I think, I'm fairly certain I have some parsley. Yes, to add in there. What else would be good? What else would be good? What else would be good? Oh, look at that, fresh parsley. All right, hand me these. And now we bring this to low because I don't want it to splatter everywhere because I don't like cleaning all the time. Who does? All right, let's put those guys in. Let them heat up just a little bit. I like to leave it nice and chunky. Here's the fun part with this step. Let's wash it first. In my elder years, I bought this. So it just cuts it in there. So you don't have to dirty stuff because you know what happens when you cut up a bunch of parsley? On a thing, it leaves it extremely dirty and little parsley specks everywhere. Now, instead of cleaning one thing, you gotta clean three. The knife, the cutting board, and the parts around the cutting board. Now, we turn it in. But hold on, before I do that, because I don't want this to cook too much. These little things are so great to snack on for keto, but now that I'm putting it in a dish, it's annoying to like pull it out of the thing. I wish I got a bucket full. I've never tried these in college spaghetti before, but there's always a first. If I had mushrooms, I'd totally add them in here. Oh man, college spaghetti will always hold a dear place in my heart, and I think that's the other reason why I like to cook it. There's a little emotional side to it. It was a lot of hard work, it was a lot of struggle, and it was a lot of like finding yourself when you're just on your own for the first time. So I enjoy it. I hope to pass it on to my son. Not some ancient decades old recipe, it's Bruschetti, boy. While that simmers over there, I'm going to make a really quick mint salad. Man, these are some long grape tomatoes. Put those aside for happy. Man, as I get older, I can't stand too many heavy things. Like it feels too heavy. So these salads really, really brighten up my palate. The smell takes me back. Don't forget to clean up as you go. Clean up as you go. In hindsight, I should have gotten a bigger bowl, but whatever. A little bit of olive oil, bunch of salt, and a whole lot of lemon. Eddie doesn't like citrusy stuff. I love citrusy stuff. And look at how luscious this lemon is. Hi. I'm a lemon. No, it don't feel so good. Ah. Make it rain, lemon man, make it rain. I used to love lemons growing up. And this is one of those lemons. You should take your fingernail. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. You know how often I get these kind of lemons? Rarely. Hold on, let the juices come out. Oh, this is taking me back to college. I used to get lemons and just eat them whole. No, my uncle would eat them with the rind. I'm like, how could you do that? Put a little bit of salt to flip it inside out.
And then you eat it. Mr. Peach. It's so good.
I can't believe my uncle used to eat it with the rind. Oh, this is a tasty looking salad. Some of it's starting to melt. That is perfect. While that still simmers, I got one more thing to do to complete College Sketty.
Revisit it.
These dinner rolls are legit. 3 net carbs, total sugars less than 1. Pop these in the micro. 2 minutes. Will you look at these cute bowls I got from Target? Oh my goodness, they're totally plastic and I'm okay with that. So they won't break, watch. Gonna throw it down. And he's looking over like, you really gonna throw that? No.
Oh man, it's gonna be good.
The juices are steaming. Okay. Oops. Okay, execution is not, okay. All right, I wasn't expecting this. Hey, the rolls are done. Get off of there. You know what else I love about College Sketty? Makes leftovers. My husband does not like salad, so he gets the miniature bowl and he has to eat it. I spent time making this, Eddie. Oh, look at that juice. I'm gonna drink that juice in there. And before these go off, they're gonna get some Parmesan on the top. Parmesan on the top. A little bit more, because we like the Parm. You gotta clean up as you go. And now it is time to take them to the placemats that I have not used before in my life. We never use placemats.
Why not?
Look at how pretty they are. Why don't we use these? Because I don't want to clean them. Check these beauties out. College Sketty. Daddy, yeah. Will you get us 2 Topo Chicos, please? Now I shall retrieve the buns. Oh, look at how soft they are. They actually taste like real bread, by the way. Look at all this leftover. This is amazing. This is gonna give us another dinner, possibly 2. Depending on what I use with it, I can make sandwiches out of that. Now I must take my picture for the thumbnail and get the butter, because butter's good for the brain. We don't know if that's true or not. My scene has been set and it's a gorgeous picture. You'll see it on the thumbnail. Yeah. All right, babe, you get the little one. Isn't it cute?
It's so cute.
This one's for you.
Thank you, Mama.
And you are the guinea. Cause look, this is what I've done different that I've never done with our Broke Sketty before. I added things.
Ooh, I mean, it's all good things.
I know,
right?
But get one of the, you can taste the difference, can't you?
It's so good.
Get one of the mozzarella balls and they tell me then.
Okay.
And I have never added that Parmesan before. Is it good? Yes!
Yeah, it's good.
Okay, look, we turned off all the lights because we don't usually live our life with all our lights on just for shooting with the cameras. But man, watch me see this and be like, man, we should do that from now on and just turn off all the lights.
No lights.
Yeah, because sometimes it might come out better. But okay, after tasting that, the addition of the tomatoes, they're warm and they explode in your mouth.
Yeah,
and then, oh my gosh, this cheese ball, this does it. Cooking with Strider. Yeah. We'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.